Thousands of vulnerable Australians are still unvaccinated as the rollout reaches a milestone of 4 million injections. The Prime Minister has been accused of being complacent on a day he gathered with the party faithful in Canberra.
The Prime Minister leaving from a basement and leaving his ministers to face the questions over his vaccine program.
We're rolling it out as quickly as possible.
Get out and get vaccinated.
It's a big task in terms of ensuring that that all Australians have access to vaccines.
A task for the Prime Minister and the Health Minister under pressure as Melbourne goes into lockdown.
And only 500,000 Australians have been fully vaccinated.
The focus here is making sure that as many people have their first dose as possible.
Like politics, the vaccine rollout is a numbers game.
How many doses do we have in Australian soil right now of both vaccines?
Well, at this point, we've had 10 million arrive.
2.5 million are being held back for second doses. 7.5 million have been distributed.
The states actually have additional supply, which to date they haven't utilised, and we're not saying that critically.
Tonight, there are still aged care homes which have not received a single vaccine, and only 6,000 out of 26,000 people in residential disability care have been vaccinated.
Ironically, our Prime Minister, whose nickname is Scotty from marketing, isn't even doing any marketing in Australia.
To boost the rollout, some states are giving Pfizer to people under 50, but the floodgates can't open to all because there's not enough supply. Next month, there will be 200,000 doses less of Pfizer than there were this month, and AstraZeneca is not recommended to people under the age of 50 because of a minute risk of blood clots.
Is there any consideration to changing that advice?
Well, that advice is given by the medical authorities.
Some inside government admit that advice is to blame for vaccine hesitancy.
We've seen hesitancy around the world.
Other countries have offered incentives like cash rewards to try and increase vaccination rates. The government here says that's not on the table and wants the health incentive to be enough.
To avoid the lottery of COVID and to avoid the lottery of death.
Jonathan Kersley, Nine News.